Let me tell you something you already know. The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done.
Pain is temporary. It may last for a minute, or an hour, or a day, or even a year. But eventually, it will subside, and something else will take its place. If I quit, however, it will last forever.
I thought to myself before my division started, I thought to myself, did I do enough to become a world champion? And am I going to make you proud because of what you did for us, all the training, all the hard work? I just wanted to prove to you. I just wanted to prove to you that I can do this. And all the things ran through my head. And it took me back to the day when you won your world championship, your world title, and you told me, you would tell us before the time, act like a world champion before that. It's not about the other things around you, all the other countries, but your hard work will pay off. So, thank you for being there and being that person in my life. If it wasn't for you, I don't think I would have been where I am today. Thank you so much.
I'm the one person that knew exactly what you went through preparing us for the world champs. You'd always come back and complain, you don't know if they're ready, you don't know if you're putting in enough hours, maybe we must add in another hour, can't we train Sunday morning, Saturday night? Your whole world revolved around preparing us for training. And through that, you sacrificed yourself and your own training. And I knew how hard it was for you to get up 5 o'clock in the morning to do your training, so that you were free in the nights to train us. All your hard work and your sacrifice, your own sacrifice, your personal sacrifice paid off. I'm one of the few lucky ones that can say I've meddled in all of the disciplines that I've trained in, but it's because of you. This is not just mine, but it is your accomplishment as well. It's a testament to you, basically, how good of a sensei you are, how good of a coach you are. Because not only here locally, but internationally you are recognized. They know who's your student. They'll come ask. They can't even speak English. They ask, good coach, they used to come to you. And we went up as our own little army, and we went up to do a job, and we did that job. We came back with 29 medals. It's a very, very proud moment, I can believe, as a sensei, but also as a team member, to know that you did your sensei proud. One of the other things is that whenever, before I compete, I know no matter where you are, if you're coaching somebody here or you're helping somebody there on the side, I know when I get into that tatami and I turn around, you'll be there behind us. And that's what we can all say, you know, not only do you train us in preparation time, but when we're on that tatami, you're the one coaching us, you're basically in the fight with us. Thank you so much for those things. We'll always be grateful to you. Thank you.
Thank you for all the training you did, but it all owned up to all the medals I got. Thank you for making me have the opportunities to go to all those places, India, Bloemfontein, Durban, Java, and I'm very grateful for that. Thank you, Sensei Clayton, for everything.
Thank you for all your support and your help. Thank you for giving us strong karate. Thanks for all your help. Thank you for taking us all around, like India and everywhere. You're such a great sensei. Thank you for all your help.
Sensei, the competition was amazing. Thank you for giving us the opportunity for us to go to the competition. Thank you very much, Sensei.
Thank you, Sensei Clayton, for everything you did for us so that we could compete in the World Cup.
I could not have made it this far without your help. But for what I'm really here is to say thank you for all the hard training that you have helped us with, and myself, especially in the kata and kumite. for bringing me this far, and although I did not win a medal in India, the experience will always be there. I will never forget it.
Thank you for being there throughout my karate career and letting me do so well in all the tournaments. I've known since Clayton almost for half my life. I'm doing karate now for 10 years and I know without him my karate will just be lost. Stay the man you are today, and I know you'll always be there for us all your students, and especially me, myself.
So, I'm not just thanking Sensei for a trip to India, but I'm thanking Sensei for making a dream come true, or at least one of my dreams come true. There's something I will remember that Sensei always used to say, and I actually felt that the tournament, but you don't have to win, as long as you fight the best fight you can on that floor. You fight it like it's your last fight, and you'll remember that fight forever.
Thanks for everything that you've done for me. I'll never forget the day that you told me, never give up, always push your hardest, even though you're tired. Push, push, push. That's what I like about you, your dedication. You're never stopping. You will help everyone, even though the class, even though there's like few minutes left, you will help that person.
I would like to say thank you for Sensei Tom. For thinking for the time appreciated as for the World Championship in India. The time and effort that the dojo has put for into preparing us for India is greatly appreciated.
So, I'm basically going to say thank you, Sensei, for all the preparation, the hard work, the blood, the sweat, the tears, the shouting, the all that exercises and page you came with every night, that it's suck for all that. I'm grateful for all the time and the effort and the hours you sacrificed just for us. And all the things you did on the side as well. Like it, stuff you didn't have to do, stuff you really didn't have to do, and necessary stuff you did just. But yeah, anyway, thank you for all you did, Sensei, for all you did for me, and Soma, I'm thanking behalf of everyone.
You've definitely made me a better person, and you've made me accept losing and defeat, but also working on it. So thank you very much, and you've made me a stronger person in a lot of ways. I've conquered many things because of things that you told me by the karate and motivated me.
So I just want to say thank you for everything you've done since working for you. I didn't have a medal in India at all. Thank you for taking up your time. Thank you, Sensei, for all you've done. Thank you. And I remember when I lost in the final, Sensei told me that, don't worry, you're still a champion. And all of a sudden, I didn't want to cry anymore.
Sensei Clayton, I appreciate all the training and time you went through me. It may be stressful, but sometimes I get it wrong and you shout me, but then you help me through. At the SA Champs in India, you helped me through the training, and the other people won't help me, but you did. I appreciate Sensei Clayton. Thank you very much.
I definitely admire how you've built up Gojikai and lost well. I mean, and now, as of recently, you prepared me for India, the first time I'd actually competed internationally. Once again, thanks for all of that.
Thanks for coaching me all the way through to India. Now that I've also made it into the EP All-Stars team, I have now gained more confidence. Thank you very much.
And thank you, Sensei Clayton, for everything.
And thank you for all your help.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sensei Clayton, for everything.
But for what I'm really here, this is to say thank you.
Thank you for being there throughout my karate career.
I'm thanking Sensei for making a dream come true.
Thanks for everything that you've done for me.
I would like to say thank you for Sensei Tom.
And Soma, I'm thanking behalf of everyone.
So thank you very much.
Once again, thanks for all of that.
Thank you very much.
I appreciate it. Thank you very much. Thank you.
told the guy, he said, when you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful. I don't know how many of y'all got asthma in here today, but if you ever had an asthma attack before, you short of breath, SOB, shortness of breath, you wheezing. The only thing you trying to do is get some air. You don't care about no basketball game. You don't care what's on TV. You don't care about nobody calling you. You don't care about a party. The only thing you care about when you're trying to breathe is to get some fresh air. That's it. And when you get to the point where all you want to do is be successful, as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful.
The inches we need are everywhere around us. They're in every break of the game, every minute, every second. On this team, we fight for that inch. On this team, we tear ourselves and everyone else around us to pieces for that inch. We claw with our fingernails for that inch. When we add up all those inches, that's gonna make the fucking difference between winning and losing. Between living and dying. I'll tell you this, in any fight, it's the guy who's willing to die who's gonna win that inch. And I know if I'm gonna have any life anymore, it's because I'm still willing to fight and die for that inch. Because that's what living is. The 6 inches in front of your face. Now I can't make you do it. Now I can't do it for you.
This kid's gonna be the best kid in the world. This kid's gonna be somebody better than anybody ever knew.
With an alligator, I done tussle with a whale, I done handcuff lightning, throw thunder in jail. That's bad. Only last week, I murdered a rock, injured a stone, hospitalized a brick. I'm so mean, I make medicine sick.
Bad dude.
Bad. Fast. Fast. Last night I cut the light off in my bedroom, hit the switch, was in the bed before the room was dark.
Incredible.
Fast. Confederates. And you, George Fulman, all of you chumps are gonna bow when I whoop him. All of you. I know you got him. I know you got him picked. But the man's in trouble. I'm gonna show you how great I am. I'm gonna show you how great I am.
The one that says you are ready, you are prepared. It's all up to you now. So rise and shine.
I'm in the building and I'm feeling myself. Rest in peace, man. I'm gonna do it for the pay, okay? Getting paid, we'll holler whenever that stops. My team good, we don't really need a mascot. Tell tune like one, pass it like a relay. YMC and P, you niggas more YCA. Me, Franny and Molly Mar, like the cribbo. Chocolate like the Nico, they ain't shun, try to get up. We got fucking with her, I don't really need her. That's how you feel, niggas really how you feel. With the pimpin' nice cold, all these bitches wanna chill. I mean, maybe she won't, and again, maybe she will. I can almost guarantee she never
will.
That she wanna photo, you already know though. You
already know. I show them over
there.
I feel like it's trending.
Yeah, as you can see, the news for the whole psyched up,
doesn't always go to the stronger or faster man, but sooner or later the man who wins is the man who thinks he can.